So throughout this course, we started with some wireframes that look like this. We kind of planned out our website, and then we designed our website in Figma. We basically used the brand and the mood to kind of inform this decision. Now, the issue that we got is Figma isn't a website builder. It's basically a design tool. So how do we go about making a website based on these designs? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to start to code these up. Now, there's a few ways that we can do this. We can actually use things like Atom, which is a code editor, or things like Sublime Text. If you've used these stuff before, you're very welcome to keep using it. If you've never coded before, we're going to use something called the SuperHi editor. Now, you can get this, just sign up for an account at superhi.com, and then you can log in at editor.superhi.com. Or you can download the SuperHi editor Mac app or Windows app and get started here. Now, I've currently signed in with my SuperHi username, and what I can do here is set up a new project. And unsurprisingly, this project is going to be called Aria Oslo. So Aria Oslo, and we're going to create this project. Now, what this will do on the SuperHi editor is it will give us a place to actually add code to. Now, this is written design tools, so pages in here, index.html is our first page that we look at. Then we have some style sheets in here. We'll talk a bit about that later. Over here, I can view my website currently. It just says hi there. You can edit your content in index.html. And I've got this next tab, which is publish. And under here, I've got settings as well. So I've got a few different options here. But what the SuperHi editor will give me is a URL. Now, if I click this and go here, I can go to aria-oslo.superhi.com, and this is on the web instantly, and it means that we can change things and they update on this URL too. So let's just try this thing out. So what does the content say? You can edit your content in index.html. So if I go back to my code section, which is up here, I've got this weird red text. This might be in a different color if we ever change the layout or change the color scheme, for instance. But this is basically a HTML tag. It informs the browser what is going on here. Now, our user doesn't see this. They just see the middle bit. Hi there, you can edit your content in index.html, which is this. Now, what we want to do is just update this. So I'm just going to quickly change hi there from Aria Oslo. And my one down here, you can edit your content in index.html. I'm not touching any of the red bits at the moment, just the text part of this. And in here, what I'm just going to say is artist in Portland, Oregon. There we go. Now, the SuperHi editor will save this automatically. If I click back into preview, we'll see here Aria Oslo, artist in Portland. If I go back here, I've got a project URL. If I click there again, this will automatically update too. And I can send this to her and say, hey, this is your holding page right now. You can take a look at this URL and see what is going on. Now, what I can also do is I can publish these changes. So if I want to freeze things in time, there we go. We're going to freeze it in time. Now, if I refresh the page, it will stay published. But if I make any changes, Aria Oslo maybe goes to my name, Rick Lomas. The final version of this doesn't change. However, I do have a preview version which has changed, and I can get the preview or the draft URL down here. So I've got my different URL, very slightly different up here with two different bits of content. So if I do want to freeze things in time but still edit them later on, all I need to do is go and publish that. Now I can go and send this URL to people and be like, hey, check out my new website. It's not quite ready yet. I want to add a little bit more style and a bit more content in here before we actually get anything done. So next, what we're going to talk about is the content of this website. How do we go from something that looks like this into something that looks a little bit more like that?